first memories. We had old scratchy records. I remember down in the basement. The first album, and I have like boxes of albums at home from when I was younger, you know, record albums. I'd say 300 or 400 of them. And the first album I ever got was an album called Beatles 66 to 70. I probably was 5.
What was it like for you growing up when the Beatles were popular?
The Beatles sort of took over and changed music, changed rock music forever. They were sort of, I'm not going to say unprecedented, but I mean, to begin, the excitement when the Beatles broke was something like, it was just like nothing like that had ever happened before. Now, I was kind of young at the time, obviously. It was 60. In the U.S., they really broke in early 64.
Mm-hmm.
So I was 10.
It's a really grounded album. I found it really beautiful. It's really centered. It's not overly complicated. It's sophisticated. I think the melodies and the music and some of the lyrics are pretty sophisticated, but it's not like what we did with Revolver, mm-hmm. where you've got all these crazy things going on in different directions and all these weird sounds and crazy countercultural themes.
Mm-hmm.
Well, you begin to see some of those. They're serious messages and themes in Rubber Soul, but not ones that to me are very confusing. There's a lot of songs about love, you know. There's a lot of songs about, you know, like Nowhere Man, kind of looking at the emptiness of mainstream society. But they're pretty straightforward songs. They're short and they're really beautiful. And I sort of I think I've always more reacted to the music than the themes of that album.
And they just created this hysteria.
Right.
And, you know, they sort of changed the paradigm from a named performer with backups who were sort of anonymous to like a unified band. Like they were the Beatles. They weren't, you know, Elvis or Buddy Holly or some, you know. And they had this... they had a sound that was the Beatles. It was different.
Right.
Not that there weren't influences and not that you couldn't find antecedents, but somehow they forged a instantly recognizable, really wonderful sound.
Why do you like the album Rubber Soul? How do you think that album was different from previous Beatles albums, and how has this influenced you as a listener?
The Beatles were so popular. You know, they were an important youth cultural influence. And, you know, this was a heady time of change and sort of shaking off the stodginess of the 50s and early 60s. And, you know, the whole hippie movement and, you know, free love and the flower power and all that stuff was kind of, it hadn't quite swept the nation yet, but, you know, it was sort of beginning to germinate. And Rubber Soul, I mean, it's not, you know, a psychedelic album or a overtly kind of druggy album, although the Beatles were already well into lots of drugs.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, what the Beatles consistently did was sort of open up a door and then push ahead and open up the next door for everybody to kind of come through. So if you listen to Rubber Soul in comparison to before it, I guess, Beatles 6, Beatles for Sale, Help. It's a different, sort of, still the Beatles, very much so, but the sound is different. It's a little more laid back. Songwriting is just spectacular. And it's got kind of a looser feel to it. And, you know, it sort of pushed all of us along. It was sort of an important part of the wave towards all this sort of, you know, hippie stuff. But it was an early, it was like an early wave. And it was very much part of feeling this change in the world, like the Beatles almost had their finger on the pulse, and that was very much part of that process.
What do you consider the best song on the album to be, or what was the most meaningful song to you, or which is your favorite?
And Nowhere Man wasn't really on it originally.
Okay.
Nowhere Man came out as a single, and they threw it onto the CD later. If I Needed Someone, I'd be curious to go back and check if that was on the album originally. That's actually written by George, but it's a transcendently magnificent song.
Great.
And the harmonies are just amazing. I love Norwegian Wood. I wouldn't call it my favorite on the album, but, you know, that was maybe, you know, that's one of these songs that you heard for the first time and said, you know, something different's going on here. There's something going on here.
I once had a girl, or should I say, she once had me. She's shown me her room. Isn't it good? Norwegian wood. She asked me to stay and she told me to sit anywhere.
The lyrics are so strange. It's a kind of a, it creates this mood through the lyrics and the music that's really very, it's not something you've experienced before necessarily listening to music.
And does that song, Norwegian Wood, does it still hold some meaning for you right now? Even if you listen to it now, would it still hold that same meaning for you?
A little less.
Mm-hmm.
A little less.
Norwegian Wood, amazing song about just this weird encounter between this narrator of the song and this woman who invites him up to her place, but he ends up sleeping in the bathtub, and she like points out her groovy Norwegian furniture.
I was alone, whispered the floor. So I lit the fire. Isn't it good, Norwegian wood?
The Beatles sort of being in the forefront of change, of that evolving, changing sound.
But the point is this, that the Beatles' influence on me, I mean, the Beatles are like in me. They're so part of who I am.
In my life, I love you.